Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over the sum product function, but we are also going to use an if statement within that function in Microsoft Excel.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So before we start, let's review both of the functions that we are going to use. First, let's go over what sum product is. If I have a set of data like I have here in this table, I can envision a scenario where I would like to take the quantity that I've sold multiplied by how much each piece cost. And then I would like to do that for every one of these five different products that I have. So I could insert another column here where I just typed equals the quantity sold times the amount sold and hit enter. And then I could double click here and fill in the values for all five products. And then I could just put a sum total here at the bottom. As I can see down here, it says 427. Or I could just click here and do equals sum, parentheses, and sum these up. And I get the same 427. But that's a very long way to go about doing this. So Excel has created a function called SUMPRODUCT, which is going to multiply one column by the value in the next column and then sum those up automatically like we did manually here. So I'm just going to click in H2 and type equals sum product with a left parenthesis. The first argument I'm asked for is array one. So what column am I going to want to use first? So I'm just going to highlight these cells right here. And then I'm going to type a comma and then highlight these cells right here. And I only have two columns that I wish to multiply together. So then I'm going to hit enter. And you can see that I got that same 427. So that's basically how the sum product function works.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. And hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Let's go over the if statement. If I click in this cell right here, G2, and I type equals if with a left parenthesis, the first argument in the if statement is a logical test. So that's basically trying to figure out if something I put in here is true or false. So in this case, I want to put in whether or not this cell here, D2, is less than 10. So that's my logical test. Is that cell less than 10? So if I type a comma, if it is less than 10, let's say I want to put in a zero. I'm going to type zero and then another comma. And then if this isn't less than 10, then I want to put the value in right here that's in the cell. So I'm going to click here, close my parentheses, and press enter. And so now if I select this cell and double click on this dot right here at the bottom right hand corner of the cell, I can fill in all of my cells with that same formula. So I can see right here where these two are coming out as a zero, which is true because 8 and 5 are less than 10. So this is calculating correctly. And this is how to use the if statement. So how would I put these two together? Both the sum product and the if statement. So let's click in H3 right here. So if I type equals sum product with a left parenthesis, my first argument is array one. But I only want to bring in these values if they are greater than or equal to 10. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to begin my if statement. So I'm going to say if with a left parenthesis, and I'm going to highlight all of my quantities, and I'm going to say that if they're less than 10, comma, I want to return a zero, just like in the if statement I just showed you. But if it's not less than 10, I'm going to put a comma again, and I'm just going to highlight my quantity. And what that will do is that will say that any values that are less than 10 return a zero, otherwise return the value in that cell. So I'm going to put a right parenthesis right here to close up that if statement. But now I'm back into my sum product statement. So my first array is getting these numbers if they are greater than or equal to 10. And then I'm going to type a comma, and I will be asked for my second array. Since I'm returning a zero here, I don't need an if statement over here, because if I am returning a zero, it's just going to multiply this number by zero and return me with a zero. So that's okay. So I'm just going to highlight these cells, close my parentheses, and press enter. And now I'm getting 296. Is that the correct number? Well, let's double check that. If I click here and I type equals sum product with a left parenthesis, and instead of picking this quantity, let's just pick where I use my original if statement. And then I'm going to type a comma and return my price, close that up, and hit enter. I am in fact getting 296. So hopefully this shows you how you can use an if statement nested inside of a sum product to sum up only certain values or return a zero if it doesn't meet that criteria. If you would like some more ways to use the sum if, check out our blog at the link below in the description. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.